The Trip's Thrill Adventure Park, a place with a long tradition. The area was opened as a leisure and recreation park as early as 1929, making it one of the oldest amusement parks in Germany. The foundations for the development of the new, now fully-fledged theme park were laid during the 80s and 90s. Trip's Thrill got its first roller coaster in 1986 in the form of a Sierra Tivoli large model. However, Trip's Thrill did not go more on roller coasters like many other parks in the 80s and 90s, but on family attractions thematically tailored to the region. Only in 1998 the second roller coaster came to the amusement park with the Gerstlauer bobsled coaster Xing the Sau. This was followed in 2008 by the wooden roller coaster Mammut. Since then, the Swabian Park, which is still family owned today, has increased the frequency of new big attractions. In 2013, the Gerstlauer Infinity Coaster with LSM launch brought an unexpected highlight to the German roller coaster landscape. The year 2020 looked very gloomy for leisure and theme parks at the beginning, slowed down by the worldwide outbreak of the coronavirus pandemic. The start of the season in Germany was also delayed considerably. But Trip's Thrill had big plans for this year and they were realized nevertheless. They opened two new roller coasters in combination. A family boomerang for families with children and a prototype. The first delivery of the suspended thrill coaster, both rides from the Dutch manufacturer Vekoma. Head over heels and full steam ahead, where family fun meets adrenaline. If you have been observing the German roller coaster landscape over the last few years, you might have noticed that another park has already successfully established a similar combination of action-loaded roller coaster and family boomerang. Fantasialand successfully established a similar concept in 2016 with the Intamin coaster Terran and the Vekoma family boomerang Raik. Now we have another example of a great combination of two roller coaster worlds in Trip's Thrill. But before we have a look at the coasters in detail, as always, we'll take a look at the datasheet. The Family Boomerang Volldampf is limited to family-friendly 250 meters of ride length, while the big sister Hals über Kopf has 800 meters of track. The family coaster with its 22 meters height does not fall so far behind the 30 meters of the inverted coaster. The rides are reaching a maximum speed of 60 and 80 kilometers per hour. The two roller coasters can handle up to 500 and 800 passengers per hour respectively, whereas Volldampf of course does not use inversions at all. Hals über Kopf, it does justice to the name and turns the passengers upside down 3 times. Trip's Thrill advertises with 4 inversions, but the so-called Junior Immelmann of the roller coaster is not considered a complete inversion, because the passengers are never turned upside down by a full 180 degrees. The theme and design. For the time being, the subject matter of theme and design in this review remains without judgment. The reason is that, as usual in Trip's Thrill, the complete theming of new big coasters is still pending and will be completed in the next years. So, Volldampf has already its largely finished station and waiting area, but should still get some changes to the environment itself. This is because the environment interacts completely with the Hals über Kopf roller coaster. The inverted coaster is still under construction as far as its station and waiting zone is concerned. Even the roof, which is broken through by the family boomerang as a little gimmick, is still missing completely. Nevertheless, I want to mention the elaborate design of the trains themselves. A lot of thought has been given to the details of the design. From the goat, which looks panic-stricken from the last car of the small steam train, at the waiting guests and apparently begs for help, to the detailed equipped carriages from Hals über Kopf, which send the passengers with spear, backpack and rations on the wild journey. Of course, all this did not happen without reason, as the two new roller coasters are once again all about old Swabian legends and traditions. Of course, we will take a closer look at the detailed stories behind the attractions in an addendum to the theming in the next years. Furthermore, the rides are placed very prominently right at the parking lot and entrance of the park, which gives the arriving guests a great view of what to expect on their day of visit. The layouts. Let's start on Volldampf. Before we go on the steam train journey, we have to do some shunting. Typical for a family boomerang, we first go backwards out of the station and up a straight ascent. At the end of which the train is briefly stopped, then follows the descent which sends the train back through the station. This is followed by a layout which consists mainly of S-curves with small hills. The family roller coaster not only interacts with the large partner layout from Halseburg-Kopf, but also crosses one of the large accessways to the area around the coasters and puts the guests in the right mood for what awaits them here. Crossing the footpath, we dive into the area directly underneath the inverted coaster to make our way between the tracks of the Big Sister ride in several curves. For the finale of the forward section, the train not only dives under a strongly inclined turn from Hals über Kopf, but after a sharp right bend, it climbs directly into the future station building of the bigger roller coaster in order to break through directly into the station area. Above the trains, waiting for passengers at Hals über Kopf, we roll out and around and down again, into reverse. This brings the train back to the station where we are gently slowed down, the wild family train ride comes gently to its end. Now on to Hals über Kopf. Loaded, secured and equipped with everything necessary, we start our adventure trip with a slight right turn which brings us into the gently grabbing lift hill. Very fast, we are now at a height of 30 meters. We have barely hooked into the lift when we are already on top and rush towards the footpath below us. Crossing the footpath, we speed in a slight right turn towards the station of Volldampf. In order not to damage it, we gently ascend and pass through a very wide 0G roll directly above the roof of the family boomerang. Very nicely placed element with high interaction factor. Behind the station, the train dives down again slightly to plunge directly under the lift hill of Volldampf. At its end, we throw ourselves into the Junior Immelmann, which resembles a high-positioned overbanked curve and initiates a change of direction. After that, the train rushes directly over a path at the edge of the new park area, including an S-curve which was combined with a slight hill to give some rows of the train even a little floating airtime. We now ascend in a sharp left turn to fly directly over the first drop we've gone down earlier. This ends in the next drop which leads into the second full inversion. The first of two long corkscrews is passed. Afterwards, it goes sharply right into a close to the ground and intense helix that unpacks some strong positive G-forces. Another small airtime hill follows. Just before we collide with our own station, the train throws itself into an overbanked turn to the left. This swings out into a twisted airtime hill to send the train into a ditch in a tight left turn. I would be interested to know if there will be a tunnel here later. For the finale, we climb out of the ditch again to throw ourselves directly into the last inversion. Again, we turn upside down in a long corkscrew element. A last ascent in a slight left turn sends us into the gently grabbing final break. The wild journey on Hals über Kopf comes to a gentle end here. The ride experience. Vekoma has worked massively on their own models and the quality of the roller coasters in their portfolio over the last years. You can feel this with every new delivery. The family boomerang full steam ahead is in the middle of the range of its sister models I've ridden. Stays less intense during the ride and thus offers families with children a rather relaxed ride through the new area. The experience is greatly enhanced by the interaction and some near-miss moments with the layout of the inverted coaster. However, the seats may appear a little cramped for tall passengers, but the design for families with children is clearly evident here. But this is not a big problem, and the ride quality of the family coaster is absolutely up to date. Bigger rail bumps or hits during the ride are not to be noticed. Due to the smaller wheels on the bogies, however, the smoothness of the large coaster models cannot be reached completely. However, this manifests itself at most by slight vibrations during the ride. So it is completely okay. Hals über Kopf again, the prototype with newly developed tracks, train and restraint systems has to prove itself as the first of its kind. But first of all, I can say that it has no problem for this new coaster model to convince myself completely. The new seat and restraint system is extremely comfortable and ensures a very pleasant ride without the passenger feeling constricted. The safety bars lock hydraulically and therefore stepless. This should enable a safe and comfortable position for almost everyone. The shape of the seats and backrests leaves hardly anything to be desired, and you feel really comfortable when entering. I would even wish for this system on the B&M inverters. This is truly a place to be. The ride quality of the track can be described as excellent. At most, here and there, a few small vibrations can be felt, interrupted by one or two small wobbles during the fast changes of direction, which, however, do not spoil the ride at all. They can easily keep up with the competition. Sometimes the ride becomes quite intense, especially in the helices and tight turns for a few moments. It doesn't even spare a bit of airtime. A novelty for inverted coasters. The transition into the lift is almost without being noticeable at all, and the final brake gently brings the train back to the starting point magnetically without any contact. A surprisingly pleasant and intensive ride is offered here. My conclusion. With its convincing prototype and classic family boomerang, the Tripsdrill theme park has created a combination that can address a very wide audience. In terms of quality, both roller coasters play in the upper league without any problems. The overall experience of the novelties is enhanced by the constant interaction with each other and the paths around and in the new park area. The sympathetic theme park surrounded by vineyards has created another highlight here, with which they don't have to hide from the competition at all. The choice to develop a novelty in cooperation with the Dutch manufacturer Vekoma proved to be absolutely successful, and the result is a roller coaster combination that shines far beyond the regional park borders. In Tripsdrill, exemplary conception meets much love for detail, which has become the trademark of the family business and has become an integral part of the German theme park landscape. Once again, the Tripsdrill Adventure Park deserves my absolute recommendation and congratulations on a fantastically successful expansion of the charming place surrounded by the Swabian vineyards. Congratulations on one of the big highlights of the year 2020. Tripsdrill, you have done everything right once again. All this is based on my own opinion and taste, of course. Do you have a different opinion? Or would you like to add something? Then let's get into the comments. I am looking forward to your opinions.